CSV. This stands for comma-separated values and is a popular format for storing data. Most of the time, people use databases for large amounts of data and spreadsheets for small amounts, but CSVs still have their place. They are simple and convenient. No drivers or special APIs are needed to use them, and Python makes them even simpler with the CSV module. Get ready to look at values that have been separated by commas. A CSV is a text file that contains data. Oftentimes, the first row of the file is a header, letting you know what the values represent. The remaining lines contain the data. Think of each row as a record in a database. In each row, the pieces of data are separated by commas. Note, because this is a text file, there are no data types. While you may mentally interpret the data as strings, dates, and numbers, everything is represented as a string. When you read a CSV, it will be your responsibility to convert the data into the appropriate data type. Also, whenever you see two commas in a row, that means a piece of data is simply missing. Today we will learn how to read and write CSVs. We will show you how to use the Python CSV module by reading a file containing the first 10 years of stock data for Google. Next, we will analyze the data. We will then write the results of our analysis to a new CSV. By the way, there is a link to a spreadsheet containing this data in the description below. You can export this spreadsheet as a CSV so you can practice the techniques you will learn today. Let's begin. Here is the path to the Google Stock Data CSV on my system. You can use the open function to display the contents of this file. There is indeed a lot of data there. To be useful, however, we need to store the data. We will show you two ways to do this, with and without the CSV module. Let us first parse the data without using the CSV module. We can quickly read the contents of the file by using a list comprehension. Let's look at the first two lines to see what we have. Notice that each line is treated as a single string. Furthermore, there is a new line character included at the end. We can use the strip method to remove any leading or trailing white space. And we can use the split function to divide the string into smaller pieces. Just pass in the string or character to partition on. This is a much better way to read each line. So let's read the data once more, but this time we will take care to remove unnecessary white space and split the string into separate values. If you now look at the first two lines, you can see that each row is now a list of data. Unfortunately, the data are all still strings. There is also another problem. What if your CSV contained data on books or movies? Many titles contain commas, so splitting on commas would split these titles. Handling problems like this is one of many reasons why you should use the CSV module. First, import the CSV module. When using a module for the first time, it's always a good idea to print the directory to see what functions and classes the module contains. Run. You can see the module contains functions for Excel spreadsheets. But today we will focus on the reader and writer functions. Let's now read the Google stock data once more, but this time we will use the CSV module. First, open the file. Notice that we specified a new line keyword argument and passed in an empty string. This is because, depending on your system, strings may end with a new line, carriage return, or both. This technique will ensure the CSV module will work correctly across all platforms. We will now create a reader function to parse the CSV data from the file. Since the first line is a header and does not contain any data, use the next function to extract the first line. And now we can read the data. To confirm that this works, let's print both the header and the first row of data. While the code may not be shorter than our earlier approach, it is much more robust. Python will parse the CSV and handle most exceptions that can arise. But there is still a problem. The data are still treated as strings. We need to improve our code by converting the data to the appropriate types. This CSV contains 7 pieces of data per row: date, open, high, low, close, volume, and adjusted close. The date column is a date time. Open, high, low, close, and adjusted close are all floats, and volume is an integer. Let's reload the data once more, but this time convert each string to the appropriate data type. In order to parse the date, we need to import the DateTime class from the DateTime module. Personally, I would have chosen a different name for the class, but I'm only a singleton. To parse the DateTime, we will call a method named strptime. This is short for string parse time. The first argument is the string, and the second argument is the expected format. Working with date times in Python is a delicate affair, so we will cover this in more detail in a separate video. Next, convert the open, high, low, and close to floats. We use open price as the variable name, since open is the name of a built-in Python function. These numbers represent the stock price when the market opened, its highest and lowest price during the day, and its price when the market closed. Volume is the number of shares of stock traded that day. An adjusted close is an alternative closing price that takes into account that prices can undergo quantum leaps due to stock splits and dividend payments. Finally, append a list containing these values to our data list. Now, if you print the first row, you can see the data are all of the appropriate type. They are no longer strings, but dates, floats, and integers. Let's now compute the daily stock returns and write them to a separate CSV. In finance, a stock return is just the percent change in price. A daily return is the percent change from one day to the next. People also look at weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly returns. Today, we will only consider daily returns. We will store the data that we compute in a file called googlereturns.csv. First, open this file in write mode. Let's create a CSV writer object for storing our computed results. To write a row, call the write row method with a list of values. Let's first write the header. Our data is luckily already sorted chronologically, so we can simply loop through it. To compute the daily change in price as a percent, we need the adjusted price for two consecutive days. So instead of looping over the data list, which would give us only one row at a time, let's create a for loop with an index instead. Notice that we will stop at the second to last row. This is because for the first day, there is not a previous day's price to compare to. Next, use the index I to get today's data. The date is the first element in the today's data list. The adjusted price is the last element in the list, which you can get with the index -1. Because the dates are in decreasing order, we can get yesterday's data using the index I plus 1. Similarly, we can get yesterday's price from the data array using index -1. We can now compute the daily return. The only data we will write to our Google Returns CSV is the date and the daily return. Run. If you look at the Google Returns file, you will see the data is there. However, the date is not formatted in a user-friendly way. Let's fix this. We will use the strftime method on today's date and pass in the desired format. We will use the same format used in the original CSV file. This method name is short for string format time. Now change the call to write row to use the formatted date and run. If you look at the Google Returns CSV file, you will now see a more friendly looking set of data. With Python, data and its commas are soon parted. The CSV module gives you everything you need to responsibly read and write data. And don't forget, with big data comes big responsibility. So parse wisely, my friends. Now go and subscribe to Socratica, because you never know when there's something you should know but don't know, but could know, if you had only subscribed to Socratica.